Happy Monday, B-Fam! Alam nyo ba, today is the Seeing Eye Guide Dog Anniversary. Kumbaga, it's a special day to appreciate the amazing dogs that serves as eyes and ears to their owners. And just like how these dogs guide and provide mga companionship, yung pakiramdam na tinutulungan ka with whatever you're doing, let's all acknowledge also the incredible humans that guide and support us on our journeys. Siyempre, you're still with me, your main boy feed, Jay Miranda, here on The Place to Be Happy, Be You, Be RGY. We all deal with personal battles in life, but having someone to share the burden can make the journey more bearable naman. And for me, no, those people na talaga nakatulong sa akin, especially yung mga difficult times, are parang two groups of people, friends and family. The thing with me kasi is parang pag it's more of a kailangan ko lang ng distraction type, I always go to my friends. Yung hindi ko naman kailangan i-share yung buong problem ko sa kanila, but I just love having company. So magaya na ako normally doon mag-lunch, mag-dinner, have a night out for example. And if it's something more serious, anything na para hindi ko na share sa lahat, diyan na pumapasok ang pamilya. Kaya super grateful ako kila mama and kasi parang alam mo pag-uwi mo pa lang, nakakamusta na agad sila. Yun lang naman yung kailangan natin eh. Isang question lang, kamusta? Minsan sinasabi natin agad na parang okay lang, masaya naman lahat, ganyan. But it's also good to really open up and makwento mo rin talaga kung meron ka mga slight problema. Siyempre, nandiyan naman sila, especially yung family mo, during the bad days and the good days as well. And kung may pinagdadaanan ka ngayon, B-Fam, nandito kami para samahan ka at bigyan ng inspiration. Kaya naman, balikan natin ang inspiring stories ng naging bisita natin kasama ang kanilang inspiration sa buhay. First on our list is a kapamilya heartthrob na nagpakilig sa atin during his stint on Pinoy Boy Band Superstar. At syempre, nagpabilib din naman siya sa atin ngayon sa kanyang pagganap bilang kano sa seryeng Pira-Pirasong Paraiso. Saan kaya siya kumukuha ng lakas para magawa ang lahat ng ito? Let's look back at Markus Paterson's story as he shares how his son na si Jude makes him stronger and better. Here's our first best of saucy. Lang naman akong quick regalo para sa'yo. So, meron tayong album over here.
May pag-gift, ha?
Of your one and only. Baby Jude.
Yung baby boy.
Diba? These are the moments na talagang asarap i-cherish, no? For sure.
Yeah, for yeah. Sure. That's his second birthday, yeah. I love how they're Polaroid. Oh my God, the first time we played football together. Yeah. We have custom jerseys made with our names.
Cute.
Shout out to Footballer PH. Thank you guys for having them made so quick. Ball pits. Oh my God, my son loves ball pits. Like, he would. If I leave him, feel like hindi ko na siya mahanap. He'd just be under the ball somewhere.
Nalunod na
yeah, sa he ball. Loves it. He loves it talaga. And now he has a new thing, it's balloons. Mm-hmm. He loves balloons now.
And now, ilan taon na siya?
He's two still. He's three in October, October 20. So he's super. Yeah, I'm gonna keep this.
And siguro mas maganda rin na isa-isay natin yung photos to really look back. Kung ano nga ba yung mga nangyari during these moments. So, at yung, again, first one natin. Ano yung story behind this photo?
This is when he his hair was growing pa. Mm-hmm. And like, it was like, I think the first week we were tying it up. So he looked like Matt Healy from the 1975. Yeah. And I was like, damn, bro.
May peg na agad na artist.
Oh, ang gwapo na anak ko, grabe, my goodness. So I was like, selfie muna tayo, anak.
Yeah,
yung naman yun, yeah.
And then, the second one is his birthday. Mm-hmm.
His second birthday. Yeah, that was a fun time.
How was the preparation for this one?
Intensive. It was it was quick. We planned it very quick. Honestly, Jay did all of the hard work. because I have no creative.
Pang like, pag events.
Yeah, and you, wala akong alam dun. I was like, honey, you got this. Like, you got this.
Also, ano, since napag-usapan na din natin yung parenthood, you said that you better understand your parents now that June came along.
Yeah.
How come? Paano man nasabi?
Okay, there's certain things when you're a kid, and like, you know, when like you want to go outside and play, and your parents are like, no, you can't. Why? Oh my God, I just want to play, blah, blah. Like, there's certain things that you don't understand what they're going through and, like, why they inhibit you on these certain things. And becoming a parent yourself kind of opens your eyes to, like, what they went through with you. Mm-hmm. So I have such a bigger appreciation for what my mom and dad went through, like, raising me, because I know I was a nightmare as a child. I was a rebellious kid. Pero talagang they kept me in check.
I thought what you mentioned kanina, first
football game namin, yeah. So I got jerseys specially made for me and my son. Cause I want him to do anything in life that he wants, but I really want him to play football. It's like that's my life. You know?
Ibigay niyo na yun.
Oh, bigay mo na sa akin yun, anak.
So totoo pala yung mga ano, yung mga kwento ng mga parents na nagbabasketball, gusto maging basketball player, anak, hindi mo nagawa.
Oh, yung parang ganun. So parang yeah. But yeah, that was a very special night for me.
How was it for Jude? Na enjoy naman niya.
Sobra. He's a bit too young to like fully grasp the concept of football, but he still loves kicking the balls around and having fun.
Mm-hmm. Galing kasi I can see how you really balance everything out. Parang when it comes to your stories, madalas si Jude pa yung makikita rin namin doon, for example. Yeah. How do you balance everything?
I leave that up to a very special person called Jerson Raven. She handles
shout out.
Yeah, shout out to you. She handles everything. Cause I cannot keep a schedule to my.
And I feel like even Jude helps you out with that. Kasi
yeah.
May sinasabi yung parents madalas, di ba, na parang pag nakita mo na yung anak mo, everything suddenly, parang wala ka ng problema, lahat ng pagod, naalis. Was it something similar to you?
Definitely, definitely. I mean, like, especially when he was still an infant, like, the first 6 months na nasa UK pa kami, of course, walang yaya, so kami dalawa ni Jay talaga nag-aalaga. Yeah, like, you're just sleepless nights, yeah. Waking up every 2 to 3 hours. Pero, like, when they wake up and they just smile at you, talagang parang, para naka 8 hours na tulog ka, like fresh agad, nakaligo ka pa
recovered na talaga.
Oh, recovered sa... talaga.
And as we mentioned kanina na si Jude sobrang bilis lumaki and all, ano yung mga dreams mo for Jude when he really grows up?
I've said this before and I just want him to be happy. Like whatever dream he has as a kid, alam mo naman natin na nung bata tayo siguro like I want to be an astronaut, I want to be you know, all that stuff, go lang. Pero when it comes to the time where he really decides on a life choice, whatever he chooses, as long as he's happy doing it, masaya na rin ako.
And in a world na both parents nasa showbiz, would you feel like may chance, if nagka-chance siya na magkahilig din sa showbiz?
Sana hindi, pero
yeah.
Hindi naman natin mapipigilan yun, di ba?
Eto, siguro medyo mas emotional tong ano, papagawa ko sa'yo. If Jude might, you know, see this episode one day, ano yung gusto mo sabihin sa kanya?
Hey, bud. If you're watching this and you're probably laughing at me right now because you're my son and we laugh at people, I just want to make sure that you know that I love you and I always will. And I'm obviously a call away. Wherever you are in life, happy or not, I'm always here for you and I love you so much.
Sinare ko na dati dito na parang one of my favorite interviews here sa BRGY is with Markus. Kasi, ano, tropahan lang talaga. Di mo na makifeel yung parang meron pang getting to know stage and nangangapapa with him. Talagang kwento lang siya ng kwento and it's those stories na especially family-related and kay Jude, yung pinakamasaya pakinggan. Kasi whenever nagsasama-sama kami, palagi niya pinapakita yung mga pictures ni Jude, nagsa-soccer training siya, ganyan, nagpapagupit and all. So you can really see how he is as a father na rin as well. Kaya naman, ang dami niyang pinaggagawa ngayon and despite his busy schedule, he still manages to make time for his son. And last year nga, no, he celebrated Jude's birthday with his former partner, na si Janela Salvador. Markus also shared an adorable video expressing how much he misses his son and assuring him also that Papa will be home soon. Keep up the great parenting, Markus! And sa mga B-fam natin, no, don't go anywhere. We have more stories of healing to revisit featuring a G-Pinoy all the way from Dubai. All that and more when BRGY returns.
Madami kami take away din sa mixed live na parang mas na-appreciate namin yung parang nagipag-interact ka sa bandmates mo while playing. So hindi lang namin dito magagawa. So sa paglabas din namin ng iba pong performances, parang mas dama na namin na kumukuha kami ng energy sa isa't isa while performing. Hola, hey, mabuhay!